Hi students, good morning. Let me continue the topic of lipids. In this session, I am going to enlighten you about classification of lipids. In fats, there are different types of combinations were there. Firstly, we have to know about simple lipids. Simple lipids are also called neutral fats. And these neutral fats are made up of combinations of alcohols and fatty acids only. There are no any other component involved in their structure. Mainly fats, oils, waxes, they are little solidified in nature, and cutanes and sebaceous, they are also secretions present in the plants. All these are come under simple lipids. When we go for the second category in the lipid classification, they are complex lipids. They are also called compound lipids. In compound lipids, we can see the combinations of fatty acids along with the fatty acids, glycerol or other than glycerol, any alcoholic group, mainly sphingosine. So this is very sphingosine is a alcoholic group component that is present in only complex lipids. Phospholipids, glycolipids, lipoproteins, sphingomyelins and cardiolipids, all these are category under the complex lipids. Generally, phospholipids we can see in membrane surfaces, cell membrane surfaces. Okay, glycolipids are also present in cell membrane surfaces. Everyone have proteolipids, so are lipoproteins, combinations of lipids and proteins. In the last sessions, we had discussed that glycoproteins means combinations of carbohydrates and proteins called glycoproteins. Combinations of carbohydrates and lipids is called glycolipids. And combinations of lipids and proteins is called lipoproteins. That's why they are called combinations of fats and other alcoholic groups. Complex lipids meaning complex lipids. The last category is derived lipids. In that, a component is deriving from main sources, mainly steroids, that are cholesterol, prostaglandins, prostacyclins and thromboxanes. All these are under the category of different types of fatty acids. One by one, we will learn and their importance. Now, let us discuss the first category of lipids. They are simple lipids. Simple lipids, already given the definition, they are esters of the alcohols and fatty acids, mainly glycerol. That's why simple lipids are also called neutral lipids. Okay. Then, they are in the form of monoglyceride, diglyceride and triglyceride. What is monoglyceride? In the last video session, I had discussed with you that formation of monoglyceride, diglyceride and triglyceride. Means here, a glyceride is a 3-carbon component, whereas here, 2 carbons are not engaging with the fatty acid. Here, only 1 fatty acid was attached. Okay, so we can call it, this is a R1. 1 fatty acid is attached, means how many water molecules are released? 1. So number of dehydrations taken place in the monoglyceride formation is 1. So what is monoglyceride? Dehydration. Only single dehydration takes place in the formation of 1 ester bond between alcohol and fatty acid. Just like that, what is a diglyceride? In this structure, R1 and R2. Means here 1 water molecule comes over there. Here 1 water molecule comes over there. So diglyceride has been formed due to the 2 dehydration process, and also 2 ester bonds are formed and 1 carbon is free from the ester bond. Next, the third one here, 3 carbon and R1, R2 and R3. There are 3 water molecules are formed here. So 3 dehydration process result triglyceride. So number of water molecules formed at the formation of a triglyceride is 3, and the number of ester bonds are also 3. So that is how these general fats or simple fats are also called neutral fats are existing in the forms of monoglyceride or diglyceride or triglyceride. Clear? Once we consume the food, in that diet fats are also present. Once fats are go through the mouth and stomach, there were no places the fats were digested, and when the fat reaches to the intestine, due to the pancreatic enzymes, the fats going to be digested into triglycerides, diglycerides and monoglycerides, later glycerol and fatty acids, then they will go for absorption process. Now, So these simple lipids are in the two categories. Number one is fats and oils. Fats and oils are liquid lipids. They are also called liquid lipids. At some room temperature, fats will be formed, and lesser than room temperature, fats becomes oils, probably 20 degrees Celsius. Now they exhibits rancidity. What is rancidity? Generally, fats and oils are hydrophobic in nature. They never be dissolved in the water. And in the long lasting, these oils and fats are occupied by some microorganisms. Though have sustainability on the lipids and oils nature, that they give some secretions, and due to the anaerobic respiration, some compounds will be released in that mixture of microbes and oils. Then a kind of odor, nothing but a smell, will come from the stored oils or stored fats. That ability where the oil is releasing some kind of a smell is called rancidity. Clear? Rancidity is not given by lipids. Microbes, though, are occupying the lipids, are producing some kind of a smell. Other category in the simple lipids are waxes. So they are liquidous in nature and they are solid in nature. But these waxes are also kind of a fats. That esterification of some kind of lipids. Let us see how they were esterifying. Lot examples are given here. Lanolin. Lanolin generally used in the cosmetics and some ointments. It is derived from some cholesterol and linestrol components. Bees waxes. Honeybee waxes, we can see. Honeybees, by their abdominal glands, they secrete the kind of chemical. These chemical are esterification of palmitic acid. What is palmitic acid? Palmitic acid is a saturated fatty acids. In the last session, I have given that structure and formula also. So, palmitic acid is secreted by the bee's abdomen and it is solidified into bee waxes. Right? Next, candle waxes. Generally, we see the candles, that is a very solid in nature. How it is solidified means the candle is nothing but paraffin wax. It is a paraffin wax and it is also secreted from plants. Next, ear wax. In ear, when we clean our ears by some earbuds and some equipments, some solid brown color nature component will be observed. That is what called earwax. That earwax is also called cerumen. Important term here, notice it. Cerumen is nothing but earwax. It is a esters of a cholesterol. In our body, cholesterol will be there. That will be esterified and forms some kind of a structure in the ear. That is earwax. Next, cutin and seborrheic. Absolutely, they are plant waxes. Plant waxes. These are released by the plants so that they are restricting some physiological functions of the plants. Let us see one by one. Cutin is a wax released by the plants. They occupy the epidermal surfaces of the leaf or stem so that they reduce the rate of respiration. Gas exchange in the plants will be reduced. Next one is suberin. Suberin is also a kind of a chemical secreted by the plant cells, mainly by the cork. Cork nothing but a part of stem. And that helps to reduce the area for water permeability. So leads to impermeable of water. So these kind of things commercially we can use. Okay. Here in the plants they are giving some harmless. But if we use them in some experiments to prevent the water, to prevent the exchange of gases in the plants, they are also experimental tools in some physiological experiments in the lab side. So this is what about the fats, oils and waxes from the first category called neutral lipids. Let us see complex lipids. When we discuss about the complex lipids, they are made up of fatty acids plus sphingosines. Combinations. They are of five types. The first one is phospholipid. What is phospholipid? In the phospholipid, alcohol and sphingosine is present. So here, the first carbon and second carbon are engaged with their respective hydroxyl group, but the third one having sphingosine. So sphingosine is attached to the third carbon, whereas first and second carbons are having their general hydroxyl groups, and they are found in mainly in the cell membrane. They helps in the transport also. Now, second category, glycolipids. In the name itself, you can observe glyco plus lipids. Glyco means what? Carbohydrates and combinations with the lipids. They are generally in cerebrocytes and gangliocytes. Both are found in brain. They help in the transport of viral particles in the brain. Third one is lipoproteins. In the category of complex lipids, we are discussing first one is phospholipids, second one is glycolipids. Phospholipids are generally present in the cell membranes. The main example I can give here, lecithin and cephalin. These two are very important examples that comes under the phospholipids. In that, lecithin is present in the alveoli membrane. Alveoli membrane means in the lungs where gases exchange takes place, that air sac is called alveoli. In that membrane, lecithin is present. This lecithin is a phospholipid which can be act as surfactant, means it increases the surface area so that more oxygen can go inside the blood and more carbon dioxide comes outside the blood through the lungs and comes out. So in the human respiratory time, the same topic we can going to discuss now. Then cephalin also. Now glycolipids, I already told you, cerebrocytes and gangliocytes present in the brain. Lipoproteins. Lipoproteins means what? Lipid plus protein. So combination of lipids and proteins together is called lipoproteins. They are associated with the cell membranes. Now sphingomyelins. Sphingomyelins. Myelin is the term already you heard in your school time also, in many sessions, so that about neuron. About around the axon there is a myelin sheath is there. So that these are the fatty layers belongs to the sphingomyelins. They form myelin sheath around the axon. Okay, where does the sphingomyelins exist means around the axon or around the neuron, that is a myelin sheath side. But how does the sphingomyelins are composed of? Let us see. The lipid without glycerol. Generally lipid means what? Glycerol plus fatty acids. But here glycerol was not there. Instead of glycerol, what is there? Amino alcohol sphingosine is present. Very, very important. Please notice that. Again, I will tell you. Sphingomyelins are generally existing in the around the neurons. They form myelin sheath. In that lipids, inside the lipid, glycerol was absent. Glycerol less lipids. In place of glycerol, means instead of glycerol, amino alcohol sphingosine is existing. Now, last one is cardiolipids. Generally, we can observe these cardiolipids in the inner membrane of mitochondria. Inside the cell, there was a mitochondria. Generally, we called that powerhouse of the cell. What is that? Powerhouse of the cell. Why? ATP can be generated in the mitochondria by respiration. In inner membrane, not outer membrane, inner membrane of that mitochondria have cardiolipids. These cardiolipids have a very important role in the generating of ATP. So this is how, these are the very basic points we learned in the category of complex lipids. Number one is a phospholipid. Number two is glycolipid. Number three is lipoproteins. Number four is sphingomyelins. Number five is cardiolipids. Cardiolipids find in inner mitochondrial membrane. Sphingomyelins are find in around the neuron. And lipoproteins are find in cell membrane. Glycolipids are present in brain and so many receptors. And phospholipids are present in the cell membranes, mainly lecithin and cephalin. You practice and you will get it definitely. Clear? The last one is that it is derived lipids. Let us see the derived lipids. Now, last category we are discussing, there are derived lipids. In that, first one is steroids. The steroids generally present in both plants and animals. Steroids in the animals are called cholesterol. Cholesterol is called animal steroid. Animal steroid. Where does it is produced in the animal or human body? In the liver. The cholesterol is also so important, but in the enough level. More than the enough level, the cholesterol is bad for us, causes obesity and high BP, blood pressure. Stigmosterol, this is called plant steroid. Plant steroid, don't think that steroids or cholesterols are present in only animals. So this is called plant cholesterol, named stigmosterol. And in the fungi also, sterol kind of structures are present. That is nothing but ergosterol. Fungal cholesterol we generally called. Fungal steroid or fungal cholesterol. Cholesterols are very bad when they exceeds their limits. They restrict many physiological functions. On the other category, the derived lipids, prostaglandins are present. They are exist in only animals. In that animals, almost of all tissues. Animals, all tissues. They have a great capacity of vasodilation. So they act as vasodilators. Vasodilators means what? They increase the area of blood vessel and makes the blood flow less. And they provide or produce hormones. They are steroid hormones. These hormones are called eicosanoids. Eicosanoids. In human physiology, chemical coordination time we will learn that. But just now we come to another. Eicosanoids are the hormones derived from prostaglandins. Mainly in the human body, in the semen, the sperm's motility is also gained by prostaglandins. In menstrual fluid, in many tissue fluids also prostaglandins are present. They also helps in many metabolic activities. So till now, you have learned about the different types of lipids that are come into only three categories. Number one is simple fats or neutral fats. Number two is the complex fats or compound fats. Number three is derived lipids or derived fats. So overall, different types of fats are there. You practice in a sheet couple of times. Make a flow chart, and with the help of flow chart only, there itself you write the examples. And beside the examples, just give an eye for and write the their importance and function. Couple of times you will learn it long lastly. Okay. I hope you understand my suggestion. I hope you understand entire the concept. Practice well and attend assignment. In the next session, I'll come with a different aspect. Thank you.